ثانية.
يب. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، we are discussing the final ayah of Surah Al-Kafirun, and we're making two additional comments, inshallah ta'ala, before I get to the final comment. The first of them is, in the previous surah, a personal attack was made against the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and his family with use of the word batara Muhammadun ma'adallah, that the Prophet's family is cut off and his name won't last. And you recall that from our discussion from the last couple of weeks. And in response in this surah, Allah Azza wa Jalla did not say to all of the believers, because it's not just the messenger himself, but it's also وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ, those who are with him, they're also not going to worship what these people worship. They're also in rejection of this. But because they thought that the Prophet by himself isn't strong enough, and the fact that if his lineage is cut off, he's just by himself alone, Allah Azza wa Jalla in this case highlighted that even the messenger alone is enough for you people. So he doesn't say قُولُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ, all of you say أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ, no. And not even لَا نَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ, we do not worship what you, no. قُلْ, you alone say to them, you stand up to them alone. You know, this is a lesson in the Qur'an. The Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in, we sometimes, from a historical point of view, people will say that the non-Muslim, the disbeliever will say that Muhammad, you know, he was a great leader, but he was nothing without his followers, ma'adallah. They use language like that. Muslims don't use that language, but non-Muslim historians do, right? That he depended on his followers. Now look at the wording of Allah. إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ in Surah At-Tawbah. If you don't help him, he tells the Sahaba, if you don't help him, Allah has already helped him. Allah has already helped him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's not our attitude. Our attitude is, he has already gotten the help from Allah. You remember in the Battle of Hunain, some of the Sahaba got shocked and they ran off, and he was by himself and the archers are above on the hill. And he's just standing there saying, أنا الرسول لا كذب. I'm the messenger. You know, I'm the son of, you know, Abdul Muttalib. I'm the messenger, I'm not a liar. And he stood there by himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the courage Allah has given his messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. This is the first thing. The second thing is, I told you that, you know, they were looking to compromise with the messenger. But Allah tells him that he's not the one you should be dealing with. These are my decisions. He's only communicating my decisions to you. So it doesn't begin, ya ayyuhal kafirun, it begins, qul. In other words, those words aren't even mine. Allah is telling me what to tell you. How am I going to be the one to make these decisions? So, at the end of the ayah, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ, that noon at the end of deen is actually dini. Dini. You have your deen and I have my deen. And there's a ya للمتكلم. It's an idafa, right? So you put a ya at the end. And for rhetorical reasons, the ya is removed. There's no ya there anymore. It's only kasra now. If you read the mushaf, it'll be لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. It's just a kasra there. So the ya is removed, right? This is a kind of hadhf, it's called hadhf in Arabic, omission, to take a word out, is used for several purposes. One of them is for exclamation. For exclamation. In other words, when you're excited and you say something like this, emphatically, then you don't say dini, you say dini. Similarly, when we beg Allah Azza wa Jal, we don't say Rabbi, we say Rabbi. Rabbi ghfirli. Rabbi short. Why is it short? Because we're desperate before Allah Azza wa Jal, and it's a cry to Allah. Here, that's one of the reasons is the emphatic power with which the messenger is declaring that this is my deen. The other is the ya would refer to the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, and his role has been minimized, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, in this declaration, as Allah's role from the very beginning has been maximized. Allah's role has been maximized with the word qul. And by removing the ya at the end, it is as though Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, in the end even, you don't mention yourself much. It's not really you who's making this decision. It's not really you, subhanAllah. It's a very beautiful and powerful and eloquent conclusion to the surah. And here's the third and the most important point that I wanted to leave you with, inshallah. I've been telling you all along in these last 10 surahs that they are not only a good depiction of the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but at the same time, the connection of the legacy of Rasulullah tied to the legacy of which messenger? Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Now listen, I'm taking you to another place in the Quran. I'm going to translate just a few words from this long ayah. قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمٌ, that already there is a beautiful model for all of you, especially in the legacy of Ibrahim عليه السلام. وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ and those who were with him. إِذْ قَالُوا لِقَوْمِهِمْ when they said to their nation, إِنَّا بُرَاءٌ مِّنْكُمْ وَمِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ we are completely disassociating ourselves from you, no doubt about it. Listen to these words carefully. They said, there is no doubt we are disassociating ourselves from you and from and what you worship, anything besides Allah. Anything that you worship besides Allah, whatever it may be, we are cutting ourselves off from you and your worship. Sound familiar? Subhanallah. And he goes, كَفَرْنَا بِكُمْ we have disbelieved in you. In other words, we are doing kufr of you people and your religion. وَبَدَى بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةُ وَالْبَغْضَاءُ أَبَدًا And now, animosity and hatred has been born between us and you forever. For that group in particular. حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ Until you believe in Allah, the one and only. SubhanAllah. And the ayah goes on about the exception of Ibrahim and he made dua for his father. When he made dua for his father. But look at the ayat. Isn't this another depiction of Surah Al-Kafirun? And how the messenger deals with the Quraysh? He is repeating, even in his animosity against the Quraysh, repeating the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Not just in فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ SubhanAllah. How beautifully Allah ties lessons together in the Quran. وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ This is how we explain the ayat. How beautifully things come together. How incredibly well history connects. And here you further appreciate what I said just a few minutes before what I said. The messenger was told to speak alone. He was told to speak alone. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, who had very few followers, even he was told to speak with the believers that were with him. The irony, you know, the contrast. Who has more followers? Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam. And Ibrahim has a few followers. We know this from history. You know, barely ever mentioning his followers. Actually, he himself is called ummatan. He by himself is called an ummah. But the few followers he had, he was supposed to stand together with them and then speak up to his nation. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has many more followers than him, he's asked, no, you go speak alone. You go speak by yourself. Because they need to see what you're made of. They need to see that they cannot be talking to you in this way. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah azza wa jal give us an appreciation of the Qur'an, an understanding of it, and a love of his messenger. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim, wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikri al-Hakim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.